so you have no means to support yourself or to redress or seek legal recourse. And it takes a long time to bring them to light. As a survivor, they need long-term care and access to a holistic program of surgical and medical support, psychological support, rehab, and advocacy. And they require, as I mentioned earlier, surgical treatment, repeated surgical treatment actually, and face numerous physical, psychological challenges as well, which require in-depth intervention from psychologists and counselors at each stage of physical recovery. So we have been debating all this morning why violence against women is permitted, what is happening in our society. So again, it's all gender-based violence. Someone in the audience was mentioning that men should be involved, and which is very right. Men should be involved, family should be involved, society should be involved, the government, legislation, everyone should be involved in this issue. It cannot be targeted just by, say, women themselves, men themselves, or family as such. So this happens for many reasons, and the pattern of active attacks vary from country to country. They may result from domestic dispute or land dispute, dower demand, or revenge. In many cases, it is a form of gender-based violence, perhaps because a young girl or a woman spurns sexual advances or rejects a marriage proposal. So my contention when I wrote the paper was that it is a woman's right that she should be able to walk the streets without fear of retribution from anyone. She has the right to say no if she doesn't want a sexual advance or a marriage proposal from someone. It doesn't come from economic independence, but this is a basic human right. A woman has as much right as any man to say no. So this shouldn't happen. A woman should be safe to walk, to say no, without fear of retribution. But this is not happening in our society.